I'm tired of listening Ricardo whining about the first Kona, so we're back. Basically, very drastically back. We've been a bit away, sort of talking, because we've been working our butts off to make this thing work and don't crash anymore during the night. So there you go. That's the explanation for the wait. So I think you all and saw.
You should explain what will happen now. The restart.
Yeah, I was going to explain. I think you all saw the talking on the chat from Extreme Marshall. So this is going to start behind the safety car, which is this Porsche 911. So we have two safety cars. We have the Ferrari and the Porsche. He didn't know that, but we have. This is amazing. On the Extreme FM, let's do two safety cars from different brands. So they're going to start behind the safety car. They are going to stop roughly about the beginning of PlayStation chicane. So that's the first chicane on a Molson straight. They're going to stop there, they're going to form up, and then the safety car is going to take them to the end of the lap and is going to pull in. When it pulls in, race is on. Green flag is on one big pileup of cars, so hopefully they won't crash into each other on the restart like they did on the start. And away we go, racing. Hopefully with more fights, because it's going to bunch up the pack, and the guys with the cars with damage nowadays don't have damage, so hopefully they will have a bit more fight in their guts to do. We are on board with Nuno Pinto, who's 10 MSR Pro driver that is going to start in the pole position, well, restart on the pole position. Waiting them to get to the end of Molson straight, which is now. They should start stopping, otherwise we won't be able to stop. Break. There you go. That's it. Nuno Pinto will start in first, he won't. Castro Villain will, then Pedro Gomes, then Nuno Pinto, then Ludovic Tagli, if he maintains the driver, which it is, then is the first of the LMP2 car, the Mera, Alexander de Mera. Then is all the packs from, it's another LMP1, and then the pack of LMP2s. James Johnson from Drag Racing. Pulling up to the boys. He's got the limiter on, which is a good thing. Xabakis as well, really close to James. So the cars in front are the Jur team from Garrett's, then is the RGPL LMP2, and then is that car in front. Who is that? Can I see? Wicks from James Wicks from Simtech Chota, first of the petrol cars. GD just James Nelson is already there, the driver for Roche Motorsport P1. Alan Cheery as well. Who is next? Wisowski for IRG Motorsport, LMP2 car. Another LMP2 pulling back. pulling by. It is.
Are they going to start along with the GTs as well?
Yeah, one big pack. It's all in the same pack. When one green flag and they all start. So the problem here is, if you are in the back, which can happen, or your teammate is in the back, and the green flag is shown, be careful on the four chicanes, especially the last one. Don't get too frisky on four chicanes on the acceleration, otherwise you're gonna spin. And spin with 20 cars behind you, it's not good. So careful on the acceleration of four chicanes. Hopefully you will give the green flag right on top of the from the start line, right at the start line. Otherwise, some drivers will be still doing the first four chicanes, and then some madness is gonna happen. I'm sure of that. The GTs are pulling back, pulling to a stop. Martin Vinish from 3Wide Motorsport. GT coming for a stop. Very distinctive Martin Vinish from Jamaica Boys, not 3Wide Motorsport. Very distinctive headlights, yellow headlights for the GTs. Brian Hall from Hall Brothers. All 27 teams are in the pack. Vitor Pazet. It's not Vitor. Oh crap, can't remember his name. This is bad. It is Vitor Pazet, yes. Brian Hall is the last one. As we get Brian Hall to catch up with these guys, the Extreme Marshall will start, and it is starting. Here we go. This is a full behind the safety car lap, so he's gonna get to the pit entrance. He's gonna get in, and then Caster Willem will receive the green flag. Hopefully won't start accelerating on four chicanes, otherwise he's gonna get complaints to his side for accelerating too soon. Coming up to the Michelin chicane is going, and then we're gonna go down to Mulsanne corner, then it's Indianapolis, Arnage, Porsche curves, and four chicanes for the racing cars. Safety car will get in before the fourth chicanes. So, Larry, looking forward for this restart?
Yeah, since I didn't see the first start of the race, when I caught the action, they were already separated by many seconds. So this should make for interesting racing.
What did I tell you about fights on the endurance? They won't put the
What
car.
did
They won't
you
put
tell
the
me?
car. They won't put the car in a gap just because Ayrton Senna says that if you no longer go for a gap, you're no longer a racing driver. They won't do that. This is endurance, this is not F1.
Yeah, but you have to see things not only from that perspective, but there are a few drivers here on this pack that actually are not endurance drivers. You know, they're just drivers, and I'm pretty sure that many of these guys won't be. I don't know. Won't be minded to risk just a bit and try to get the car just alongside their opponent. I don't know. Just have to wait and see.
Yeah, we'll wait and see. Nuno Pinto there trying to get some heat on front tires by locking up. Arnage. Do you know all the name of the corners now? It's not that hard. We'll see. So getting to the Porsche curves, and I'm pretty sure Carsten and Pedro are getting ready for one hell of a battle for the first Dunlop chicane of this restart.
Yeah, and actually I'm just seeing that most of the teams actually, even if they're the driver that was behind the wheel when the server crashed, even if that driver wasn't over. His
they changed.
His, yeah. They changed. Most of them changed. Yeah, you have Lucien Messard was Nuno Pinto's time, but he did it already. Pedro as well.
So we're gonna go to the start, and they are going to form up. Custom will have the green flag in a bit. First he has to form up with all the others. We'll see all the LMP2, LMP1 behind the forming up, and we are somebody crashing there in the background, which is not good. The GT cars, we knew the GT cars would be a problem. Oh, big crash there. Rush Motorsport, I think. And we are racing. Castervilm goes away. Pedro Gomes tries to defend the position from Nuno Pinto. Further back, obviously the battles are going on. And I think the cars, LMP2 cars losing a position there for the LMP1. Nothing to worry about.
Yeah, but apparently everyone got
away.
Got away. Yeah, in the first corner. Yeah.
That's good. Pedro Gomes now having to defend from Nuno Pinto, and I'm not sure if they have the same amount of laps, but Nuno Pinto is trying to into the inside of Mulsanne straight, as is Andrew from James from Simtech Chota in the LMP2 car. This one is fighting for position. Jer Racing is already on top of the LMP2 car, so LMP2 now is gonna suffer from this restart. Nuno Pinto goes through, which is good. Demera,
yeah, great,
lost
a great
two positions
by Nuno on outbreaking there, Pedro.
Demera losing two positions for the LMP1 cars. Giri trying to unlap himself from one of the LMP2 cars from our GPL Czech team. Pedro Gomes now having to defend from Ludovic Tagli, and Tagli having to defend from James. is trying to pass. Tagli having to defend from James Weeks and Garrett from Jur Racing in the yellow DHL car. Now Tagli managing to get a decent amount of advantage. Pedro Gomes in front.
Actually, you should we should mention this because the start from the leader of the race, which is now well held, right? He did an amazing job. He went early and he went off. He created a little gap just on the first corner, and he's been building there ever since. And by the end of the first lap, he has already a comfortable lead over Noon.
Yeah, exactly. And the GTs, everyone went well, apart from that crash, big crash on the start. Someone spinning. Stefan Pro, Ricardo Corazzori in his back. I'm not sure if the lap amount between these two were the same. If they were, this is a battle for the first position in the GTs. They have Marco Aiello right behind him. Marcelo Aiello right behind him, but it won't be a problem because Marcelo is still IP2 and these two are GTs. So this is a battle for first position at the moment. We didn't see if the laps at the end of when the server crashed were the same. If they were, this is a battle for first position and this is a really good battle, which we're gonna leave because apparently the LMP2s are in each other's throats. Giri trying to get himself round, and this is a battle for 5th position. You can see there Garrett's trying to pass James, and he's gonna manage to stick the move. Yeah, on PlayStation chicane. Yes, it does. Oh, goes wide. Really wide. Oh, coming back. Crash.
I think they touched there, didn't they?
Yeah, contact between Jur Racing and Simtek Choda. The man that is gonna obviously take some credit for it is the mirror, which will try to pass Garrett's. He's already on slipstream, but on an LMP2 trying to pass an LMP1, even though it's an LMP1 petrol, it's never easy because LMP1s have a massive amount of straight line speed. Giri didn't manage to get himself past the LMP2 from RGPL Czech. Jim Johnson is right behind him. Then it's Xavakis. Then it's George Rojo. Come on, man, get yourself around. Not winning anything by being behind him, but anyway, that's his race strategy. Just said that Ricardo Corazzari just passed Stefan Pro. And this is the battle for one position, fourth position to be exact. Ooh, the LMP2 car there being squashed between the LMP1s. James is all over Tagli. I said LMP2, no, it's LMP1, Petro. Oh, Garrett goes to the inside, nope! Things. You see, Hilario, they don't. They don't go when
I told
they,
you. Yeah, but I told you this would make interesting racing, and there you go.
Yeah, James tries to go to the inside on the lap corner, and EU contact there a bit. Managed to stick with touch, nothing to worry about, at least at the beginning. Oh, Peter Gomes going wide on the chicane. Now he's going to lose the position, 3 wide for the next corner. Tagli trying to go to the inside, and he does, goes from 5th to 3rd in one corner. Amazing move from Ludwig Tagli. James losing a position momentarily, was 3rd, now he's 4th, 5th is Gerrits. Oof, almost on Tetra Rouge, staying there, not Tetra Rouge. Massive amount of fights for 3rd position. Inside view from the car of Simtek Chora on slipstream to the Audi. Try to outbreak him, no he doesn't. PlayStation chicane. Again the slipstream. This is like F1, just more exciting than F1. Slipstream. See here being sucked into the back of the Audi. So I lost a bit of position there by braking too early. Let's see how he managed to get himself back on the gearbox of the Audi. He obviously, and Gerrits losing a position for Peter Gomes. Peter Gomes managing to pass again. So after that mistake in the Dunlop chicane, Pedro retrieving the position, Gerrits didn't give up yet. You can see Gerrits, he didn't give up yet, so he's gonna try. On board with Gerrits, with Pedro in front of him. In Indianapolis, are you crazy? Trying to go inside. Great exit for all Gerrits and gets bogged down by Pedro. But it would be a great exit if he would bogged down by Pedro. Pedro has slight damage on the right back. Nothing to worry about.
Yeah, we're on board with which driver?
Ludwig Gerrits from Jerry Racing.
He's pushing really hard, isn't he? He's trying his best.
Oh, goes to the inside on the Porsche corners.
Again.
No. Just showing the car.
Yeah, he's really pushing. He's really trying to take Pedro. And I don't know. I'll listen to our comments. Either he crashes trying or will eventually.
Porsche gains, showing the car again, not having a look. Great exit from Porsche gains, great exit from Porsche gains. Excellent corner, and he's gained a position on the
yeah,
lap corners.
Yeah. He did a great job, a great maneuver. I actually thought that he was going to be outrun in the straight, but didn't happen. So great job from this track.
Yeah, and again the difference already. Pedro, I think he doesn't have a problem. He's saving fuel. He's gonna lose the position for LMP2 if he doesn't pick up the pace, because Alexander De Meyer is already there. Alexandre de Meiro.
Yeah, but still Pedro's position, it's not fifth actually, because I believe that they will some time from this session with the other one, and from what I've heard they were doing second place. In the other ones, so
they are.
Yeah, and they had a really, really nice, comfortable gap to third position. So, they're actually on the roads. They may be running fifth, but actually they're not.
So we'll see. We'll wait for the confirmation of the laps, and then we're going to call the shot. At the moment, we're following Riccardo Corazzari. He managed to get himself around Stefan Pro. Stefan Pro, meanwhile, didn't give up the place that easily, and he's chasing Riccardo Corazzari. Frenchman versus Italian. Very good. Hilario, Ricardo Ferreira was saying that you acquired the taste for commentary.
Well, as I said before, was something that I never tried before, and well, actually, it went pretty good, and I actually enjoyed and had some fun doing this. So, I don't know. We can actually think of repeating this sometime in the future.
Well, tomorrow. following Stefan Pro.
I have no idea if I'll wake up at time.
Yeah. Well, I will, one way or the other.
I'll use that as my cue, so it's getting kind of light, and I have to do stuff, so this is where I'll leave Enrique to it, and I'm going to have some rest, so I'll see you guys probably tomorrow.
Yeah, thank you very much, Hilary, for your help. Guidance of the broadcast when I'm here, and good night.
No problem. Good night.
Cheer. As far as we're going to stay with the Porsche, or the battle of the Porsches, Riccardo Corazzari versus Stefan Pro. Oh, my brother is sick. In the bed. Oh, he's gonna die. No, he's not. No, he's not. He's not gonna die. Daniel Faber having to... Well, a traffic jam behind him of LMP2 cars. Oh, no, one LMP1. Faber from 31 Motorsport with the Ferrari. Ooh, someone there. No, it wasn't. I was gonna say that someone went off on push curves. Didn't. Still pretty much the same positions. Oh crap. Something I forgot to do was to put the gap from live timing working. Sorry, just noticed that now. Back on working. Daniel Faber trying to get to Stefan Pro is not that far away. Still, it's quite far away. So all the laps are being added, so I can tell you by the laps that I'm watching now, the top 5 is Carsten Wilhelm is P1, P2 is Nuno Pinto, P3 is Pedro Gomes, P4 is Ludwig Tagli, P5 is Stephen Morrow from E-Racing Propulsion and the first of LMP2. So, very good racing for the LMP2 guys. Louis Sikorsky. Lukas Sikorsky, sorry. I'm changing the names all over, sorry. Too much time looking at the names and live timing, and you start to going mad. So Lukas Sikorsky, the man who's got a name that looks like a chopper, and it is. There is a chopper that is named Sikorsky. So there you go. He is at the moment at laps being corrected at P5 in the GTs. Still waiting for the correction of laps. So that will take a bit to be corrected. Martin Vindisch from Jamaica Boys. Brian Hall, which is, if I'm not wrong, the last man in the race at the moment. Obviously without the laps being corrected, so we have to wait until the laps are corrected to see if he is still that or if he climbed in the leaderboard. With Brian Hall, I'm gonna leave you with Brian Hall after the graph. Carlos Avianza. the 430 from Pro Race Simulation being lapped by GD. 307 car. Ugly Ferrari with a V8 engine mounted in the middle, and it is a four liter engine now. I was gonna say it correctly, but I had to resort to my notes. As the rest settles in, I hope you guys settle in as well. This is the night shift, as we call it. Oh, damage. Poor Canyon, Underbush Motorsport GT car. It had a small crash in the beginning. Well, big crash in the beginning. And we're still waiting for the laps to be corrected and added to the drivers. So, but I have all the laps and we can start commentating, really. A driver that he's been driving for a long time is Michael Kadlik from Team RGPL. Another driver that has been driving as well as Vidra. Vidra was done what, 5 hours in the car, which is a load. So yeah, this team is going for long haul stints, literally. As we go on board with them in the Porsche, and I go to another pit stop, really quick pit stop. Merci. Sorry about that. It was a bigger pit stop than I was expecting to be. We are with one of the LMP2 guys, Pedro de Oliveira, Club AV. It's one of the new teams. We've been watching him. Them. They are a Brazilian team. We didn't watch them very often on this broadcast. You had quite a few laps on board with them. Brazilian team that is having a good race. Steady race, obviously. Not on the top, as you might imagine. Still waiting for the lap corrections, which are taking a while to do. One by one is always hard to do. And the leader has done 160 laps in this race. Meanwhile, Nuno Pinto is making a new fastest lap on this session. Another man that we didn't watch that much is this one, Jorge Rojo. Didn't watch them very often, but I'm still racing. As you can see, very good looking Acura dashboard. He is at the moment P5 on the LMP2s, steady race as well for the FIVR team. Have a kiss. Ooh, going sideways on Mulsanne corner. Another driver that we rarely see, but still they are racing. Have a kiss that is from Lead Racing Team with another Acura. And Nuno Pinto done a 3:20.1. This is the fastest lap on this session, and he's making already a fastest first sector. So driving really hard. Xabakis is trying to get round Ricardo Corazzari, manages to, before Arnoux. This is the man on the move. He's done fastest. Well, Caston Willem is now doing the fastest first sector. He's responding to the Pinto fastest lap. So this is the man on the move, inboard, on board with Cassim Willem going to Indianapolis, braking heavily to Indianapolis, getting the car down. There you go. Coming out. Flat out. Then Larnage, first gear corner. Get your power down. Be careful, don't go over that curb. Away you go. Push curves. First left under is flat out, which will be this one, flat out. And the second one is right under, is almost flat. And then it's all flat out at the end of the push corners. Apart from this one, obviously. Mozambique, flat out. Final of Mozambique, flat out as well. Push. Now is push corner then. Four chicanes. Don't get two curves on this one. Get all curves on this one, especially this one. There you go. Great. Four chicanes then by custom. Now has Sikorsky to get rid of them. Yeah, it does. Just bumping up my microphone post, otherwise you guys won't hear me. Finished lap. Let's see the time. Time was 2:20.9. Traffic. Basically, it was that for Castrum Velum not making the fastest on the race. Let's see between these two who is doing what on this current lap. PlayStation chicanes, or Thrustmaster chicanes, as Ricardo says. Now, judging by the distance between Castrum Velum and Nuno Pinto, Castrum will lap Nuno Pinto again, so making two laps into the difference for the lead. Just tweeting a couple of things. Not very patched action Twitter, just to be said. And if you're wondering how much time is left for the race, go to live timing, and the live timing is now showing the time of race. We have 13 hours and 17 minutes to go. A lot of time to go, believe me. So Castervillum posting 3:19.4, fastest lap on the race. As for Stephen Morrow posted a 3:28. Well, James Johnson's posted the fastest lap 3:28.673, and then the P2s. Ricardo Corazzari, meanwhile, on the GTs, posted a 3:54.0. With the laps corrected at the moment, this is the battle for first position on the GTs. If I'm not wrong, it could be. I'm usually am. We'll see. Nope, it's the fight for second position. I knew I was wrong. So Ricardo Corazzari is first still, second is Stefan Pro, and Daniel Faber is third, and they are separated by something like 13 seconds between first and third in the GTs. So there you go. Just have to wait for all the laps to be added, and then we're gonna do our run up of the leaderboard. That's the Porsche from Stéphane Pro in front of Daniel Faber, and then the other Porsche in front of Stéphane Pro is Ricardo Corazzari, if I'm not wrong. Yep, exactly. These two cars are being lapped by the leader of GTs, so they're not in a fight. Ricardo driving a very steady race. Stefan Pro trying to chase down Ricardo Corazzari. At the moment he is 9.2 seconds behind Ricardo, and Daniel Faber is 4.8 seconds behind Stefan Pro. Magnus is by far the way. Almost collecting the Nupindo there. This is by far the closest battle that we have on track. For the lead, at least. Anil Faber trying desperately to get hold of Stefan Pratt, not having a very good and easy job to do. Stefan Pratt is really quick. But all the laps are not still completed, so you have to wait. 8.1 seconds behind Stefan Pratt to Ricardo Corazzari, and 3.8 for Daniel Faber as Ricardo Corazzari goes to the pits, and Faber climbs to second. Ricardo Corazzari in the pits. Stefan Pratt is now first in GTs. So Ricardo stopped one lap. Now maths. Ricardo is out. He's already coming to the track. 1:41. So Ricardo is stopping first. Stefan will stop in the last in 5 laps time, maybe? We'll see. Stefan Pratt now has to make one hell of a lap if he wants to gain some time in the pits. The leader of LMP2 coming by. Stefan Pratt, they're being chased down by a traffic jam of LMP2 cars. Somebody joined my channel, which was Rui Freire. Car 106 had a massive crash, apparently. Is nursing to the pits, and it was Jer Racing. So Jer Racing had a crash. They are okay now. Porsche curves for Stefan Pratt. We'll see. If Stefan Pratt stops now, well, Daniel will pass, that's a fact. But will he manage to keep Ricardo Corazzari behind him after the pit stop? Doesn't come on this lap. Neither does Daniel. So, Hui, are you here to talk or just to make presents?
I don't know, just to make presents, see how you're going, if you're already asleep or not. I heard some nuances in your voice and you're getting ready to sleep.
Not actually, I'm quite awake.
Bring enough coffee?
Yeah, I brought a cup of coffee now. Had a major pit stop, I had to bring coffee to the table and so on. So, you know, it's one of those things.
Cannot even watch the feed, the video feed, so I don't know if the countdown is showing or not.
The countdown.
Time. It isn't, but the countdown is already working correctly for past midnight.
Yeah, it's 1 hour ahead, but it's working okay. It's supposed to be 13 hours and 5 minutes, but apparently the live timing on the broadcast seems to be in 14:05. Not a very good perspective, is it?
Oh 14:05, it's correct.
It is. My live timing is showing 13:04.
I was watching the feed as 14.
Okay. So, Stefan Pop, still leader of GTs. Still not coming to the pits and not thinking on it. So yeah, the broadcast countdown is showing 1 more hour than it is, so it is 13 hours and 3 minutes or something that is left for the end of the race. So, nothing to worry about. I think I'm gonna need to get some rest in the meantime, whatever. We'll see. No, new fight. It is between Nuno Pinto, if he stops losing time to Pedro Gomes, and Nuno Pinto and Pedro Gomes for the second position. Caster is coming to lap Nuno Pinto, that's a fact. He's already on top of him. Oof, Nuno Pinto almost losing the car there. But you could see the Peugeot there from Project XTR, and Nuno Pinto is setting his target there. So the fight for second position overall is on. Castellum being stuck behind Nuno Pinto for the time being. Nothing to worry about. Plus one lap to Nuno Pinto and plus one for Pedro Gomes. Almost making two. Quiet now. The race will settle in, as always, and when it does, you basically want to get a slip, because these guys are going to start racing, nothing will happen. But until then, we're going to continue talking with you. You can see Pedro Gomes there in the distance. You can see Nuno Pinto. This is a fight for second position overall. And you can see the leader right behind Nuno Pinto. So Nuno Pinto is almost being lapped for the second time. On board with Nuno Pinto, chasing down the Peugeot from Pedro Gomes and being chased down by Castellum. How the hell did Nuno get so close to Pedro just from Porsche corners before she came? I don't know how I did that. But anyway, the fight for second position is on. Someone there on the wall. And Nuno goes to the inside of Pedro. On the S's. Managed to get out. Yep, sticks it. Good move from Nuno Pinto as he climbs for second position. As for Caster, he's gonna lap Pedro again for the second time. For Nuno, would be good if Pedro could delay Caster a bit, but apparently he can't. So Caster will lap Pedro. Oh, closing the door there. So in about 1.5 stints, Zen MSR will change drivers for Ricardo Ferreira. So all the difference that Nuno makes on this stint and a half will be lost by Ricardo. That's for sure. That's another fact. Kasser managed to lap Pedro.
I believe all the laps have been loaded already and everybody is looking in their correct places.
Let's see. Yep. So, run up of the leaderboard. First 3-1 Motorsport LMP1 with Casa Willem is first. Second is Lucid MSR with Nuno Pinto with plus 1 lap. One lap difference. Pajic XTR Pedro Gomes is plus 2 laps for the first position of Caster Willem. As for fourth, it's Team RGPL HDO with Bosek Giri. P5 is someone else. 51 Racing with Ludovic Tagli. Simtech Jordan is P6 with Jordan Weeks. I said James, it's not. Someone in this top 5 just disappeared. So top 5 is Jordan Weeks. A is P5, P6 is E-Racing Propulsion.
Six was Simtech Jota Arden.
They are here. Alright. Jer Racing is P7. Kevin Garrett, P8. Then is a Racing Propulsion with Seven Moreau. Jacob Hojek is a P9 with Team RGPL Czech. Check is P2 on LMP2s and P9. P10 is Reg Racing with James Johnson. Marcelo Aiello with Killer Motorsport is P11. P12 is leader racing team with Xaba Kiss. FVR team is P13 with George Rojo. John Nelson from Rush Motorsport is P14. P15 is IRG World Racing with Dominic Savecki. Cooper Racing P16 with Facundo Lopez. Pedro de Oliveira with Club Ave is P17. P18 first of the GDs is RFD Racing with Ricardo Corazzari. Stefan Fra is second on the GDs. And P19, P20 is 3-wide Motorsport GT with Daniel Faber, Mater Findish, Jamaica Boys is P21, SRW is P22, if I'm not wrong.
Yeah, you're going great.
Lukasz Sikorski. No, I mean, it's live timing. Disappears and appears, refreshes, so I couldn't see. Rush Motorsport is P23, Kurdish Canyon. Michael Kadlik is from Team RGPL GT P24, P25 is Pro Race Simulation, Carlos Avianza Guillermo Fernandez from Club Ave is P26, P27, and last is Hall Brothers Racing with Lenny Hall, which changed with his brother Brian Hall a couple of laps ago. So fastest times are from Stefan Pra on the GT 3:54.0. In the LMP2s, if the lifetiming finishes refreshing, is James Johnson from Drag Racing 3:28.2, and then the fastest lap on the race is from Castor Film with 3 Wide Motorsport 3:19.4. So going with GTs cars, passing by them very quickly. Ricardo Corazzari there, oh, going very wide on Tatra Rouge. Oh yeah, so Nuno asked from the car, which is racing obviously, what you think about his race at the moment. I think that was for me or to you as public. I cannot decipher. I'm betting it's for me. If it is for me, it's going well, apart from Custer being right on your ass. So Nuno asked if I'm enjoying the race. Ricardo, which is the man is passing me the answer or the question, asked me what did I think about Nuno's race until that moment. So I don't know. The race is going okay. At the moment, a lot of fights. Obviously, the race is settled in, which means fighting. Ooh, Nuno going wide on the final corner, which means that fighting for position on this kind of racing is more hard because everyone has pretty much settled in on their position. They are now on race pit strategy kind of thing, and the only thing that will change during this race, or during the positions on the positions during this race, will be on the pits. As for track action, we won't be watching that much of a track actions. Xavakis going really good behind Stefan. It's not a fight for position, it's a fight to take one lap off Stefan, because Stefan is coming to the pits. So that's the reason why Stefan was so going so slowly. James Johnson. Wake up. From Drag Racing.
Hello.
Hello. I'm not bored, I'm tired. It's different.
Yeah, it's kind of funny in our room at the moment. How are you?
I'm not bored, I'm just tired. It's just a difference. It seems like the same, but it isn't.
Yeah, but
So how is the racing for you guys? You guys have been up and down the racetrack.
Yeah, I think it's going okay. Jordan's doing his first stint at the moment, and he's going a lot quicker than I thought. He hasn't even tested his setup or in the dark, so he's going quick. But he's a kind of funny problem at the moment. There's some fly called a crane fly, I think it is, and it keeps bugging him, and yeah.